Live from NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, California, and on Mars, I want to present to you the team that has brought us back to Mars tonight.
So, about an hour and a half ago, I went outside and looked toward the west, and I saw Mars there, and I said, in an hour and a half, you are going to have a visitor. And the planet smiled, and I knew that we were going to have good luck.
Policy. And a guy who was sweating through this, and as he told me a little while ago, he thought he was going to throw up.
Well, today on Mars, history was made on Earth.
Okay, guys, before we start, we have a new picture of Mars. Come in. I'm sure all of you want to hear about how things went. Well, tonight was a great drama that was played. I felt like an adventure movie, but in reality, I kept telling myself, this is real. This is real, what's happening, and what a fantastic demonstration.
And congratulations to all of you again.
I felt like an adventure movie. And just think what an inspiration to the young people in the world. It's really inspiring. This is how inspirational. And what a bargain that we got this mission for. This movie costed you less than $7 per American citizen. And look at the excitement that we have brought and the inspiration that we have brought. This movie costed you less than $7 per American citizen. And next week, and next month, and next year, we'll be bringing new discovery every day, every week to all of you. And we are going to continue.
There are many out in the community who say that NASA has lost its way, that we don't know how to explore, that we've lost our moxie. I want you to look around tonight, all those folks with the blue shirts, think about what we've achieved. I think it's fair to say that NASA knows how to explore, we've been exploring, and we're on Mars. And the rover is made in the USA. And just to stay in character, we've been on the surface for 1 hour, 8 minutes, and 16 seconds. And certainly for the 7 minutes of terror, has started to weave, you know, an unbelievable story. As we get ready to transition to surface ops, I think what we really need to pay attention to now is that the Curiosity story is just beginning.
So that rocked. Seriously, was that not cool or what? So that rocked. Seriously, was that not cool or what? And is that Mount Sharp? What can I see there? And all kinds of stuff. And so he's definitely, he's got the keys pretty soon. Not quite yet, but pretty soon he'll have the keys. Yeah, and then here, Dr. Stelzner has been the father and the mother and everything in between of the landing system we've built. So. Say something profound.
I am terribly humbled by this experience. I forever, secretly, have felt that I do not deserve to be in the position of leading the team that I lead, because they are certainly in sum and largely by count of individual more capable than I. Soup to nuts, and I think that this nation is a truly great representation of a corner or a piece of humanity that reaches out and explores and conquers and engineers. We are kind of tool makers, agriculturalists, pioneers, and that's reflected in the activities and actions and results of tonight. So I want to say thank you to the blue shirts. Certainly this beautiful theater of tonight, the drama of us all being able to experience it together, unrivaled in the experience for all of us. And with that, really, I have nothing more to say. That picture says it all for me.
I think that is the best picture of Mars I've ever seen. The money, $2.5 billion, we don't put it in the rover and send it to Mars. We spend it here on Earth. And Charles mentioned at the beginning that this whole enterprise, if you divide it by every woman, child, man in this country, comes out to be the cost of the movie. I know, I speak on behalf of all my colleagues in science, that's a movie I want to see. So, thank you all.
Adam, tell us about the landing.
All right, Greg. I can't tell you too much about it. I mean, it looks good. I'm being a little flip. In short, it looked extremely clean. We touched down in conditions that were on the more benign side of our nominal expectation. By the way, I want to preface everything. This is preliminary data scooped with the sieve in the cacophony of the control room during the celebration, right? And largely by my good friend Miguel San Martin, who's somewhere out there. I hope. At any rate, very nominal, remarkably good. Our navigation error was on the low side of our expectation, which meant that we probably had a good alignment between the celestial center sensors and the inertial sensors, the IMU. Our powered flight appears to have been excellent. If my good friend Ben Toma is in the house, is Ben in the house? So it looked good, in short. Good and clean. And it looks, at least by my eyeball, that we landed in a nice, flat spot. Beautiful. Really beautiful.
What? I have to ask you, what kind of file type? Can you tell us about the image file type and compression that was used to send this very important couple of thumbnails back from Mars?
Yes, unfortunately, I absolutely cannot. If Justin Mackey is in the room, or there's a couple other people on the team who'd be able to whip that out quickly, but I don't, couldn't tell you. Sorry.
Are you going to call your daughter Curiosity? Okay, a serious question. A little more than 48 hours ago, you told me you would tell me a secret. Once Curiosity landed, can I have my secret?
Yeah, what was this? A lot has happened in the last 48 hours. And to be very truthful, I do not recall what that secret was.
For the landing that go down to something like 5 decimal points. I just wanted to confirm with you that you do have them, have those sort of coordinates. And am I reading those coordinates correctly when I see that it looks as though you've landed within 500 meters of the skirt around the mountain? That, I mean, you're really very close to the mountain at the closer end in the landing ellipse, and possibly within striking distance of the phyllosilicate trench.
I can't confirm that. My estimate, I'm looking for somebody, yes. There's somebody in the audience here who has that in the tip of their noggin.
Looking at the picture and trying to figure out from there where we are, I would imagine by tomorrow's press conferences, they should have a better idea where it came down, within a few hundred meters at least, hopefully.
Okay, the next question's over on this side.
Was when Adam asked for OD-278, and they said, no, we only have 277. What was happening, or was it anything of significance?
No.
And what a bargain that we got this mission for. This movie costed you less than $7 per American citizen. And look at the excitement that we have brought and the inspiration that we have brought.
Sometimes when this place gets kind of empty, sound of their breath fades with the lights. I think about the loveless fascination under the Milky Way tonight. Lower the curtain down in
Memphis. Seriously, is that that cool or what?
Woo! Woo!
I got no time for private consultation under the Milky Way tonight. Wish I knew what you were looking for. Might have known what you would find.
Seriously. Is that not cool or what?
Woo!
Something shimmering and white. It leads you here.
And at the NASA briefing today, they called the surroundings Earth-like and admitted it looks like the Mojave Desert for all you conspiracy theorists.
Despite your destination.
Seriously, is that cool or what?
Woo!
Everybody seated. Everybody seated.
Wish I knew what you were looking for. Might have known what you were finding.
Agriculturalist. My good friend Miguel San Martin is somewhere out there. I hope. Soup to nuts. If Justin Mackey is in the room, or I'm looking for somebody. Yes. There's somebody in the audience here. noggin.
This movie costed you less than $7 per American citizen.